Very good morning to all the students of class 10th D. Yes, beta, we are doing this chapter, the 100 dresses part 1. I told you that this chapter is actually having another part also, and very interesting chapter based on classroom setting. Fine. Yesterday I basically discussed the characters with you all so that you can have idea that who's going to be part of this chapter. Fine, and now you have better understanding of all the characters. Students are still joining, so I'm waiting for more students to come. Clear? So today I have written, you can say, theme based on the chapter. Yesterday we discussed the characters, but there were some students, those who were absent. Let me give you a brief introduction again. We have particularly three characters round which this story would be revolving. First is Wanda. She's the protagonist. Her full name is Wanda Petronsky. She's an American Polish girl, fine, hailing from such community which is not acceptable by others because she's having a different name also, fine. And then we have Peggy, the most popular girl of the school, who wears different dresses, having curly hair, and who's having, you know, some people are having high notions about themselves. They are in high air always. So she's that kind of girl, Peggy, always making fun of Wanda Petronsky. And Wanda is quite opposite to Peggy. Wanda hails from very poor background. She is a quiet girl, does not talk much. Nobody has seen her laughing out loudly. Fine. She just smiles sometimes, and that smile is also, you know, with very difficulty she smiles. And then we have Maddie or Madeline. Her full name is Madeline, but nickname is Maddie. Maddie is a friend of Peggy. Clear? So you should know all the characters. Peggy's friend. And Wanda Petronsky is the protagonist, main character. That's why I always write protagonist in the at the first place. So the scene is, they keep on teasing Wanda because she wears just one dress, blue color dress, on daily basis. And Peggy keeps on, especially this is Peggy who makes fun of Wanda, not Maddie. Madeline is there because she never says or raises voice against Peggy. So she's also, you know, you can say the part of this group. So Peggy keeps on making fun of Wanda Petronsky because she wears only one dress, and she keeps on, you know, nudging others and asking, okay, how many dresses do you have? And Wanda would be answering daily on the same answer. She would be giving 100 dresses all lined up, 100 dresses all lined up in that way. Clear? So Peggy then burst into laughter that how this girl can say, the girl who wears one single dress on daily basis, she says, I have 100 dresses. Then another day she would be asking, how many pairs of shoes you have? Wanda would be saying, 60 pairs, all different, all lined up in my closet. Again, Peggy would make fun of it, and Madeline was also there. Madeline is also not a rich girl. She also hails from poor background, but not as poor as Wanda. Clear? Wanda lives in, who will tell me? I won't speak now. You know that most of you. Tell me quickly, raise your hand. Where does Wanda live? Tanya is the first one. Yes, Tanya.
Boggins Heights.
Boggins Heights, fine. So, Wanda Petronsky, she lives in Boggins Heights, okay? And Boggins Heights is a place where poor people live. Mud is there, and she walks to school on daily basis, and daily her boots are filled with dirt. They are caked with mud, and that thing also, Peggy also makes fun of that thing. And Wanda sits in a corner of the class where all the rough boys who do not like to study, who get low marks, they sit. Wanda is not bad. She's not, you can say, a rough girl, but she sits because nobody talks to her. Fine. Nobody is making friends with her. That's why Wanda has alienated herself from rest of the class. Clear? So this is the scene. I repeat it again. Now coming back to the theme, I have written 3 points here. There are more themes into it that you will be telling me. First is the major theme is discrimination. Fine, on the basis of background, on the basis of how you look, the way you dress up, fine, the way you carry yourself. This is discrimination, bhedbhav, fine. Second thing is judgmental attitude. We should not, you know, judge others by seeing the appearance. Sometimes people are very intelligent. By seeing the dress, we cannot comment this person seems to be a fool. No. Your dress is, yes, one should be presentable, but we should not be judgmental by seeing the attire of a person. Okay? Or we should not have preconceived notions about others. Mostly we see the amenities, the luxurious life, and then we start associating qualities with the person. So one should not be judgmental. Third is empathize with others. Empathy. What is the difference between sympathy and empathy? Anybody can tell me? What is the difference between? Anyone is there? What is the difference between sympathy and empathy? I have written empathize with others. Not a single child. You would be, you know, searching on net. I wanted quick answer. So let me tell you this. Empathy means when you... Okay, Dakshita. Yes. You have raised hand. You can speak, Dakshita.
Ma'am, empathy means when we experience someone's feeling, and a sympathy means when we understand someone is suffering from something.
Yes.
We.
I got your point. Very good, Dakshita. Well done. So sympathy is when you have feelings for the ones who are suffering. Yes, but empathy is when you yourself, when you put yourself in the shoes of others, that what if it happens to me, that kind of thing, fine? When you feel the pain of others, that is called empathy. Situation can reverse at any time, fine? The way Peggy used to make fun of Wanda, and situations can be even Maddie. You know, Maddie was empathizing with Wanda. That's why I have written empathize. Maddie is also a poor girl. She's having empathy for Wanda, but she's not opening up because she's scared of Peggy. That if I stop my friend Peggy, then she would also make fun of me one day. That I also don't dress up nicely. And even I'm a poor and don't live at very rich place, you can say. Doesn't come from rich background. So that's why she was empathizing, but she was not opening about it. Clear? So let's continue reading, and then I will be showing you video also if time will be there. Okay? If time allows. So we are on this page number 65. As you can see, this curly girl, curly hair girl, Peggy, along with Maddie and other children. And this is alienated girl. Alienated means to remove from the group. Usko alag kar diya gaya. Fine? So this is the girl. Wanda Petronsky. Fine. Now let's continue. Wanda, Peggy would say, in most, have we read this paragraph? Wanda did not have any friends. No. We have to read it from here after questions. Fine. We have done these question answers also. Those who have joined today, kindly note down. Okay. Wanda Petronsky, most of the children in room 13 did not have names like that. They had names easy to say, like Thomas, Smith, or Alan. There was one boy named Bounce, Willie Bounce, and people thought that was funny, but not funny in the same way that Petronsky was. So Wanda Petronsky, I told you, because she was hailing from American Polish society, her name was different than others. So people would make fun of her name also. People means the fellow students. And there was one child whose name was Willie Bounce, and children found this name also a little bit funny, but not as funny as they would consider Wanda Petronsky. So she was being treated badly by others when it comes to her name, when it comes to her same dress which she was wearing, or her caked boots with mud. Fine. Wanda did not have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that did not hang right. did not hang right means she was not having iron to press it. That's why there could be seen wrinkles all over. Fine. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. She did not have any friends. But a lot of girls talked to her. This is the time Vivan Uppal to enter the class. Fine. It was clean, but it looked as though it never had been ironed properly. She did not have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on worn hard ground. Hopscotch is a game in which children hop into and over squares marked on the ground. They just jump like bunnies, fine? So means there were not many friends to this girl, but few girls would talk to her whenever she would stand and watch little girls playing hopscotch. Then Vanda, Peggy would say in a most courteous manner as though she were talking to Miss Mason. Miss Mason is the name of the teacher. So Peggy, you know, was very sweet while talking, but actually she was not. The way she would ask Vanda on daily basis, what was the common question she would ask? She would ask Vanda, giving one of her friends a nudge. A nudge means in that way, ki dekhna abhi I'm going to ask and how she reacts. And jaise hum kisi ka mazak uda rahe ho, and where we do na, hey, okay, listen, I'm just going to tease her, let's see. After giving a nudge to Madeline or other friend, she would say that, tell us, Vanda, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? 100, Vanda would say. 100, exclaimed all the little girls incredulously, and the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. When would they talk to this girl? Whenever she would go to ground and she was watching the little girls playing that game of hopscotch. Then also these girls would surround along with Madeline and along with this Peggy. And they would ask Vanda, how many dresses? 100. And all the little girls also, they stopped playing and they would listen. 100. All lined up, said Vanda. Lined up means in a line. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. That's it. She would not utter any other word. She would say 100. Yeah, 100 all lined up. What are they like? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. And she's adding more, you know, fuel into the fire. She was saying, okay, 100, it must be silk dresses. You know, silk is very costly. So she said, yeah, all silk, all colors. Then Vanda would answer, yeah, all silk, all colors. Yeah, all colors are mere paas, silky. Velvet too. Second, you can say priority. Velvet is also considered one of the costliest material. Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses. Where it is? Yes. Vanda would repeat stolidly. Stolidly means not showing any feeling. Why she was not showing any emotion? Because this girl is not being talked to politely since ages. In all the years, this girl has been maltreated, discriminated. So that's why she is in habit of keep mum. She's not talking, fine? All lined up in my closet. Then they would let her go. And then before she had gone very far, they could not help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. Means, loudly they would laugh when Vanda would go a few steps away. They would burst into laughter after. Means they start mocking at Vanda Petronsky. 100 dresses, obviously. The only dress Vanda had was the blue one she wore every day. So why did she say she had 100? What a story. How many shoes did you say you had? Again, the next question next day. 60 pairs all lined up in my closet. This is the answer given by Vanda. Cries of exaggerated politeness greeted this. All alike. What does it mean? In very polite way, Peggy is asking that all are same, 60 pairs? Oh no, every pair is different. All colors, all lined up. This was the answer given by Vanda. Peggy, who had thought of this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friend, were always the last to leave. So everyone would leave, but these two friends, Peggy and Maddie, would stand there till last. burst into laughter, making fun of Vanda on daily basis. Finally, Vanda would move up the street, her eyes dull, her mouth closed, hitching her left shoulder every now and then in the funny way she had, finishing the walk to school alone. She would nudge her shoulder on daily basis. Now, let me tell you one psychological fact. When you read psychology, now you'll get to know the children who have been alienated or the children who are facing some abuse at home or by others or any problem or any trauma if they have faced. Now, there will be a change in their body language. You might have seen some children biting their nails all the time when they get nervous. You might have seen many children, you know, their hands start shaking whenever any teacher asks them a question. Whenever they see a question paper, there are butterflies in the stomach. It happens to everyone, but in serious cases, I'm saying there will be a change in body language. Some people start staring at one place, they will not look here and there. That shows lack of confidence. So, you know, you have read her left shoulder every now and then she keeps on hitching. What does it mean? She is also lacking confidence. She is scared because others are not making her comfortable. But if a child is comfortable by parents, by teachers, getting proper atmosphere everywhere, that child will be full-fledged confident child. And sometimes there are overconfident category also that I won't talk now. Okay. So you can say she has become introvert. She does not talk much now. Peggy was not really cruel. She protected small children from bullies. So they are telling one more trait of Peggy, that Peggy was not really cruel. She used to help little girls also from bullies. Bullies are the ones who are bullying the little girls. And she cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. And even if she saw an animal being mistreated, she would burst into cries also. If anybody had said to her, don't you think that is a cruel way to treat Vanda? And now the question arises, if Peggy is having empathy for animals, empathy for little children, why don't she treat Vanda nicely? She would have been very surprised. What is the answer given by Peggy? Peggy would say, cruel. Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? Usko lagta tha ye jhoot kyun bolti hai? Why Vanda says that she had 100 dresses if she does not have? Anybody could tell that was a lie. Everybody knows that she's telling a lie. Why did she want to lie? And she was not just an ordinary person else. Why did she have a name like that? Anyway, they never made her cry. Fine, they were not making Vanda Petronsky cry, but yes, they were teasing and making fun of her. As for Maddie, this business of asking Vanda every day how many dresses and how many hats and how many this and how many that she had was bothering her. So this was bothering her a lot. Maddie was poor herself. Why Maddie was feeling bad? I told you now, Maddie was having the feeling of empathy, but she was not saying. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes. Hand-me-down means old clothes. I'm talking about Madeline Beta now, fine? Firstly, I talked about Vanda. Then I talked about Peggy's traits. Now I'm talking about Madeline, friend of Peggy, who's also poor. She would wear old clothes. Thank goodness she did not live up on Boggins Heights or have a funny name. Sometimes when Peggy was asking Vanda those questions in that mocking polite voice, Maddie felt embarrassed and studied the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them round and saying nothing herself. Maddie would change her attention by counting the marbles or by looking here and there, by not paying attention to what Peggy was doing. Why she's doing? Because she wanted to speak for Vanda, but she's not taking her stand because she's herself scared for herself only, that one day people would mock at her poverty. Not that she felt sorry for Vanda exactly. She would never have paid any attention to Vanda if Peggy had not invented the dresses game. But suppose Peggy and all the others started in on her next Now the question is, Madeline is thinking she can be the next Wanda Petronsky. Means students can make fun of her also, make fun of Maddie also, because she's also poor. She was not as poor as Wanda perhaps, but she was poor. Of course, she would have more sense than to say she had 100 dresses. Still, she would not like for them to begin on her. Begin on her means she does not want others to make fun of her. Who? Maddie. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda Petronsky. So she is not taking stand for Wanda, but yes, she is wishing that one day Peggy would stop teasing Wanda. Now we have oral comprehension check. We are left with two more pages, or I can say almost three pages. Yes. Now you would answer the questions, beta. In what way was Wanda different from other children? Parina, you can speak, beta.
Wanda was different from other children because she was a Polish immigrant. Moreover, she lived at a poor locality, Boggins Height, and she had an unfamiliar name, Wanda Petronsky.
All the points covered, well done. So why she was different? She lived at a different place, Boggins Height. Others were not living there. Her name was different, Wanda Petronsky, which was not like others. Fine. And she coming from that American Polish background, all the points covered, okay? So, next question. Did Wanda have 100 dresses? Why do you think she said she did? Now, this question, I don't want you to answer from your help guides or answer books you are having. You just think on the basis of the story we have read so far. That did Wanda have 100 dresses? Why do you think she said she did? Why did she say so? Divyansh? Divyansh, you can speak. I have given you the... You have raised hand, Divyansh. Are you able to speak?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Please speak loudly, Divyansh.
Wanda did not have 100 dresses. Because she was a poor girl and having old clothes, she said that she had 100 dresses because she designs 100 dresses at home in order to...
I'm not able to listen clearly. The first part is clear that she did not have 100 dresses. Any other child who can answer this question? Maybe some voice related problem. Any other child who can give answer to the same question? Bisam, Chahat, Daksh, Dakshita, Harsimran, many students are there. Only Divyansh has raised hand. So on the grounds of the story we have read so far, Wanda did not have 100 dresses. Why do you think she said she did? So here you have to speculate only that maybe she does not want to be mistreated or mocked at by others. And maybe this is her way of responding to them. They keep on teasing. And maybe she might have those 100 dresses, but in another form. And that form will be disclosing to you tomorrow. Why is Maddie embarrassed by the questions Peggy asks Wanda? Is she also like Wanda or is she different? Tanya.
Maddie is embarrassed by the questions Peggy asks Wanda because she is also poor and afraid to get mocked off. She felt so embarrassed because she also wears hand-me-down old clothes. She is also like Wanda and she is also poor, but she is also different in the way as she is not as poor as Wanda.
Fine. So Madeline is embarrassed by the questions because she imagines that one day such questions would be asked to her also by Peggy and her friends. She could relate herself to Wanda because she also hailed from poor background. She also used to wear old clothes given by others. Fine. And that's why she would feel embarrassed that one day she would be treated or mistreated by other students. Clear? So tomorrow we would be continuing from today, even though they had been late to school from here onwards. Okay, so tomorrow we'll be able to finish this. Any doubt to anyone? Whatever we have read so far? Yes, children? Everything is clear?